Our installation of Firebase has successfully installed, so we'll go ahead and then import FireAuth module. Fire module dot initialize application. So under initialize application, we'll navigate to environment dot Firebase. So after initializing our application to Firebase, let's first register the user Firebase before we create a login. So for us to be able to register the user, we'll first create an alert message to let us know whether we have successfully logged in or registered. So we'll create a function which is called alert all, and our function will take in a header, and the header will be of type string, and then also our function will take in our body, which is a message, and this message will also be a type of string. So having defined that, so we'll have to apply an async to our application. If async is applied to a function, simply means that the function at which the async is applied to, it will be returning a promise. So, and our alert controller will have a promise that will be returned if it's executed. Okay, so that having said, we'll go ahead and say this dot. So if we add an await to the promise, this await will wait until the promise settles and return its results. Okay, let's go ahead and then await. Oh, we have an error here. We have an error. Oh, sorry. Need to supply the brackets here for this. So. Also, buttons will be small buttons. Sorry. Good. So our alert controller has been created. So we'll apply this alert controller onto our register page and test it to see. Okay, save, and then let's compile our application, which is Ionic Cordova. Run. Okay, so let's go ahead and click register. Good, you see we have a beautiful alert dialogue which says successful, user has registered successfully. Good, so if you click, it takes you back to login. Let's register our user. So having defined that, we need to capture the form data elements, but so we need to go to register.html and then capture these elements into our application. We go back to our register.ts file and then we define these variables. Okay, so try catch. So here we say const, create a constant variable, which is response equal to await. Remember, this will be this is a function, so we apply an async onto our register function. Register function will have to return a promise when we register the user, so we need to add an await onto our function, onto our promise. So this will be await. this.auth.createUser with sign in with email and password. So we pass in the user with email and password, and that will be username and password. Good. Okay, so we put in our error message into, so when this function is called, it will have to await for the response of our promise, which will be the user email and password registration, to see whether we have successfully created and connected to Firebase. If the response is true, then you'll have to pass in an alert message. Okay, so let's go ahead on the emulator and then try to register a user and password of 12345 and 12345. So if we register, we get an error. Password should be at least 6 characters, but then still we need to log the information that is being presented to us from Firebase, so we can console log response. So comma, then we put res, we pass in res to our console. After that, we need to go to Safari, then browser, and then under developers I will go to simulator and then select local. So as you see here, this is the message that we are getting when we try to register. Let me first run this. Okay, our application has finished compiling. Okay, we select our local device, which is the emulator, and then we click on register, because we are not yet, we don't have any user registered on our application. So we register one user, call them maybe admin, and we pass password of admin. And confirm password of admin. So we click register. But when we click register, we get an error. Let's go to where we catch our errors and console this error. So we say here is a message error. Okay, so let's go into our application, and then we have an error. So a user can't be redirected when this result has not returned. So if the promise is returned, then we navigate the user to login page. So the reason why we are not being navigated to a login page is we haven't returned any promise yet. So we'll go ahead and try to format this email. Into, remember, we are registering a username as a single user without an email, and when we go to the Firebase cloud, we can see that go to sign in method, can see that the parameters that are required for our login are email and password. So if we just pass in a username without formatting it as an email, we will not be able to register. Okay, let's go ahead and and try to fix that. So on my email, instead of passing in direct emails, for our example, I will try to, but we'll sort it in my next video. But for now, we'll just try to make a temporary fix, and the temporary fix will be appending an email format onto this username that is being entered. So we'll say username at maybe we can call it codeaxin.com. So we have just appended this to our username that is being added for us to be able to register our user with just a username. So we have formatted our email the way it should be, and when we save and compile, okay, our application has finished compiling. So we go to our register. Admin. Okay. Now we get a clear message that we need to receive from. So here we get a weak password. That is the error code that is being presented to us, and the message being our password should be at least 6 or more characters, and let's say 1 2 3 4 5 admin. Even here 1 2 3 4 5 admin. So that's our password for our admin. So we click register and we get a successful response. So we get a response here in our console. You can see that. So if we expand this, see that we have an object that is being returned to us, and this object contained a user. And if we go ahead and expand the user, we see that we have an email that is being registered, which is admin at codeaxin.com. So this is the email that we have appended this email format onto our username, which is admin. We can go ahead and check our database. So when you go to users, you see that a user has been registered with an email of admin and a user ID of this. Okay, so we have successfully created a register page. So if you're not a user, you can register and then you'll be redirected to this. This is a login page where you can, log in and then access the application. Thank you for watching. See you in my next video. Don't forget, subscribe on my channel for more new videos that are coming up.